Welcome to the channel for you.
Native Americans in the United States. Native Americans, also known as American Indians, First Americans, Indigenous Americans, and other terms, are the indigenous peoples of the United States, sometimes including Hawaii and territories of the United States and sometimes limited to the mainland. There are 574 federally recognized tribes living within the U.S., about half of which are associated with Indian reservations. Native Americans, as defined by the United States Census, are indigenous tribes that are originally from the continental United States, plus Alaska Natives. Indigenous peoples of the United States who are not American Indian or Alaska Native include Native Hawaiians, Samoans, or Chamorros. The U.S. Census groups these peoples as Native Hawaiian and other Pacific Islander. The ancestors of living Native Americans arrived in what is now the United States at least 15,000 years ago, possibly much earlier, from Asia via Beringia. A vast variety of peoples, societies and cultures subsequently developed. European colonization of the Americas, which began in 1492, resulted in a precipitous decline in Native American population because of new diseases to which they had no immunity, attacks by whites, ethnic cleansing, and enslavement. After its formation, the United States, as part of its policy of settler colonialism, continued to wage war and perpetrated massacres against many Native American peoples, removed them from their ancestral lands, and subjected them to one-sided treaties and to discriminatory government policies, later focused on forced assimilation, into the 20th century. Since the 1960s, Native American self-determination movements have resulted in changes to the lives of Native Americans, though there are still many contemporary issues faced by Native Americans. Today, there are over 5 million Native Americans in the United States, 78% of whom live outside reservations. California, Arizona, and Oklahoma have the largest populations of Native Americans in the United States. Most Native Americans live in small town or rural areas. When the United States was created, established Native American tribes were generally considered semi-independent nations, as they generally lived in communities separate from white settlers. The federal government signed treaties at a government-to-government level until the Indian Appropriations Act of 1871 ended recognition of independent Native nations, and started treating them as domestic-dependent nations, subject to federal law. This law did preserve the rights and privileges agreed to under the treaties, including a large degree of tribal sovereignty. For this reason, many, but not all, Native American reservations are still independent of state law, and actions of tribal citizens on these reservations are subject only to tribal courts and federal law. The Indian Citizenship Act of 1924 granted U.S. citizenship to all Native Americans born in the United States who had not yet obtained it. This emptied the Indians not taxed category established by the United States Constitution, allowed natives to vote in state and federal elections, and extended the 14th Amendment protections granted to people subject to the jurisdiction of the United States. However, some states continued to deny Native Americans voting rights for several decades. Bill of Rights protections do not apply to tribal governments, except for those mandated by the Indian Civil Rights Act of 1968. Background. Since the end of the 15th century, the migration of Europeans to the Americas has led to centuries of population, cultural, and agricultural transfer and adjustment between Old and New World societies, a process known as the Columbian Exchange. As most Native American groups had historically preserved their histories by oral traditions and artwork, the first written sources of the contact were written by Europeans. Ethnographers commonly classify the indigenous peoples of North America into 10 geographical regions with shared cultural traits, called cultural areas. Some scholars combine the Plateau and Great Basin regions into the Intermontane West, some separate prairie peoples from Great Plains peoples, while some separate Great Lakes tribes from the northeastern woodlands. The 10 cultural areas are as follows. Arctic, including Aleut, Inuit, and Yupik peoples, subarctic northeastern woodlands, southeastern woodlands, Great Plains, Great Basin, Northwest Plateau, Northwest Coast, California, Southwest Oasis, America. At the time of the first contact, the indigenous cultures were quite different from those of the proto-industrial and mostly Christian immigrants. Some northeastern and southwestern cultures, in particular, were matrilineal and operated on a more collective basis than that with which Europeans were familiar. The majority of indigenous American tribes maintained their hunting grounds and agricultural lands to use the entire tribe. At that time, Europeans had cultures that had developed concepts of individual property rights with respect to land that were extremely different. The differences in cultures between the established Native Americans and immigrant Europeans, as well as shifting alliances among different nations in times of war, caused extensive political tension, ethnic violence, and social disruption. Even before the European settlement of what is now the United States, Native Americans suffered high fatalities from contact with new European diseases, to which they had not yet acquired immunity. The diseases were endemic to the Spanish and other Europeans, and spread by direct contact and likely through pigs that escaped from expeditions. Smallpox epidemics are thought to have caused the greatest loss of life for indigenous populations. William M. Denovan, noted author and professor emeritus of geography at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, said on this subject in his essay, The Pristine Myth, The Landscape of the Americas in 1492, "The decline of Native American populations was rapid and severe, probably the greatest demographic disaster ever. Old world diseases were the primary killer. In many regions, particularly the tropical lowlands, populations fell by 90% or more in the first century after the contact." Quote, estimates of the pre-Columbian population of what today constitutes the U.S. vary significantly, ranging from William M. Denovan's 3.8 million in his 1992 work The Native Population of the Americas in 1492, to 18 million in Henry F. Dobin's Their Number Become Thinned, 1983. Henry F. Dobin's work, being the highest single-point estimate by far within the realm of professional academic research on the topic, has been criticized for being politically motivated. Perhaps Dobin's most vehement critic is David Hennage, a bibliographer of Africana at the University of Wisconsin, whose Numbers from Nowhere, 1998, is described as a landmark in the literature of demographic fulmination. Suspect in 1966, it is no less suspect nowadays, Hennage wrote of Dobin's work. If anything, it is worse. After the 13 colonies revolted against Great Britain and established the United States, President George Washington and Secretary of War Henry Knox conceived of the idea of civilizing Native Americans in preparation for assimilation as U.S. citizens. Assimilation, whether voluntary, as with the Choctaw, or forced, became a consistent policy through American administrations. During the 19th century, the ideology of manifest destiny became integral to the American nationalist movement. Expansion of European American populations to the West after the American Revolution resulted in increasing pressure on Native American lands, warfare between the groups, and rising tensions. In 1830, the U.S. Congress passed the Indian Removal Act, authorizing the government to relocate Native Americans from their homelands within established states to lands west of the Mississippi River, accommodating European American expansion. This resulted in the ethnic cleansing of many tribes, with the brutal, forced marches coming to be known as the Trail of Tears. Contemporary Native Americans have a unique relationship with the United States because they may be members of nations, tribes, or bands with sovereignty and treaty rights upon which federal Indian law and a federal Indian trust relationship is based. Cultural activism since the late 1960s has increased political participation and led to an expansion of efforts to teach and preserve indigenous languages for younger generations and to establish a greater cultural infrastructure. Native Americans have founded independent newspapers and online media, recently including First Nations Experience, the first Native American television channel, established Native American studies programs, tribal schools and universities, and museums and language programs. Literature is at the growing forefront of American Indian studies in many genres, with exception only to fiction, which some traditional American Indians actually find insulting due to conflicts with tribal oral traditions. The terms used to refer to Native Americans have at times been controversial. The ways Native Americans refer to themselves vary by region and generation, with many older Native Americans self-identifying as Indians or American Indians, while younger Native Americans often identify as Indigenous or Aboriginal. The term Native American has not traditionally included Native Hawaiians or certain Alaskan Natives, such as Aleut, Yupik, or Inuit peoples. By comparison, the Indigenous peoples of Canada are generally known as First Nations. History. Settlement of the Americas. It is not definitively known how or when the Native Americans first settled the Americas and the present-day United States. The prevailing theory proposes that people migrated from Eurasia across Beringia, a land bridge that connected Siberia to present-day Alaska during the last glacial period, and then spread southward throughout the Americas over subsequent generations. Genetic evidence suggests at least three waves of migrants arrived from Asia, with the first occurring at least 15,000 years ago. These migrations may have begun as early as 30,000 years ago and continued to about 10,000 years ago, when the land bridge became submerged by the rising sea level at the onset of the current interglacial period. Pre-Columbian era. The pre-Columbian era incorporates all period subdivisions in the history and prehistory of the Americas before the appearance of significant European influences on the American continents, spanning the time of the original settlement in the Upper Paleolithic period to European colonization during the early modern period. While technically referring to the era before Christopher Columbus's 1492 arrival on the continent, in practice the term usually includes the history of American indigenous cultures until they were conquered or significantly influenced by Europeans, even if this happened decades, or even centuries, after Columbus's initial landing. Native American cultures are not normally included in characterizations of advanced Stone Age cultures as Neolithic, which is a category that more often includes only the cultures in Eurasia, Africa, and other regions. The archaeological periods used are the classifications of archaeological periods and cultures established in Gordon Willey and Philip Phillips' 1958 book Method and Theory in American Archaeology. They divided the archaeological record in the Americas into five phases. Lithic Stage Main Article, Lithic Stage Numerous Paleo-Indian cultures occupied North America, with some arrayed around the Great Plains and Great Lakes of the modern United States and Canada, as well as adjacent areas to the west and southwest. According to the oral histories of many of the indigenous peoples of the Americas, they have been living on this continent since their genesis, described by a wide range of traditional creation stories. Other tribes have stories that recount migrations across long tracts of land and a great river, believed to be the Mississippi River. Genetic and linguistic data connect the indigenous people of this continent with ancient Northeast Asians. Archaeological and linguistic data has enabled scholars to discover some of the migrations within the Americas. Archaeological evidence at the Galt site near Austin, Texas, demonstrates that pre-Clovis peoples settled in Texas some 16,000 to 20,000 years ago. Evidence of pre-Clovis cultures have also been found in the Paisley Caves in south-central Oregon and butchered mastodon bones in a sinkhole near Tallahassee, Florida. More convincingly but also controversially, another pre-Clovis has been discovered at Monte Verde, Chile. The Clovis culture, a megafauna hunting culture, is primarily identified by the use of fluted spear points. Artifacts from this culture were first excavated in 1932 near Clovis, New Mexico. The Clovis culture ranged over much of North America and also appeared in South America. The culture is identified by the distinctive Clovis point, a flaked flint spear point with a notched flute, by which it was inserted into a shaft. Dating of Clovis materials has been by association with animal bones and by the use of carbon dating methods. Recent re-examinations of Clovis materials using improved carbon dating methods produced results of 11,050 and 10,800 radiocarbon years BP, roughly 9,100 to 8850 BCE. Archaic period. Since the 1990s, archaeologists have explored and dated 11 Middle Archaic sites in present-day Louisiana and Florida at which early cultures built complexes with multiple earthwork mounds. They were societies of hunter-gatherers rather than the settled agriculturalists believed necessary according to the theory of Neolithic revolution to sustain such large villages over long periods. The prime example is Watson Brake in northern Louisiana, whose 11-mound complex is dated to 3500 BCE, making it the oldest dated site in North America for such complex construction. It is nearly 2,000 years older than the Poverty Point site. Construction of the mounds went on for 500 years until the site was abandoned about 2800 BCE, probably due to changing environmental conditions. The Oshara tradition people lived from 700 to 1000 CE. They were part of the southwestern archaic tradition centered in north-central New Mexico, the San Juan Basin, the Rio Grande Valley, southern Colorado, and southeastern Utah.